Hello friends, Ray Bohax, Successful Farming Engine Man. And I want to talk to you today about turbochargers. Turbochargers and diesel engines go together like bacon and eggs. And they've been a mainstay on farm equipment and now in pickup trucks for many years. But it's really hard pressed for you to find a diesel that's normally aspirated and not turbocharged. So it's time that us farmers learn a little bit about turbochargers, because a lot like electronics and electricity, it's been a great mystery. The turbocharger does not know whether it's on a gasoline engine or a diesel engine. So what I'm going to tell you today applies to any turbocharged application. The turbo unit itself has what some people call a cold side and a hot side. But the actual name for it is, this is the turbine side, which is the exhaust driven side, and the compressor is the cold side. So the exhaust operates the turbine, which is basically like an old grist mill. The exhaust goes past the turbine and spins it. And then what happens is that it spins the compressor, and the compressor forces air into the engine. We could do a whole segment on that eventually, and that's called an increase in volumetric efficiency, or how much the cylinder gets filled with air. This is called a cartridge, and this is the unit that has the turbine and then a compressor wheel, and it has, some of them will be liquid cooled, have engine coolant go through it to cool it, and it will always have an oil feed line. It's important that if the turbo ingests anything, specifically on the compressor side, it'll bend or ruin these fins, which will cause a problem. It'll have a reduction in boost, but more importantly, it will actually cause it to be out of balance, and then you will wear the bearing here. A lot of people talk about wastegates. What a wastegate is in a turbocharger is a pressure relief valve. When the turbo builds too much pressure due to the conditions that the engine is operating under, it's the safety valve. But many people have not seen it. This actually is an internal wastegate. What it is it's a flapper valve, as you could see here, and there's an actuator that's set up to it, that's connected to it. When the turbo boost, the boost manifold pressure gets too high, it actually moves this open, and then some of the exhaust bypasses the turbine wheel and controls the boost. It's that simple. So if you have a diesel that's low on boost, what you need to do is check all the connections, the inlet connections for the exhaust and for the compressor side, because you could be leaking. But if this wastegate disc gets carbon underneath it, then it's not going to seal. It's like a leaky faucet, and it's going to drip, and you're going to have a low boost, low power. Well, lots of times the tractor, or the engine, I should say, becomes lazy. It doesn't want to pull like it did before because of the leaky wastegate. The other thing I want to bring into mind is that the turbochargers use a floating bearing. And what will happen is, when the engine is off and you were to take the shaft and you were to move it up and down, because it's a floating bearing and there's no oil pressure there, it'll have a little bit of play. But the thing that you need to check is that when you move it and you spin it by hand, it does not hit any place. It's that simple to be able to check your turbocharger and understand it. You have a blessed day, and I'll see you next time from Columbiana, a Firestone test farm.
Hi, I'm Dave Mowitz. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit subscribe right here if you haven't already, and click that little bell right here to be notified when we post a new video. And click here to see more great videos.